What's up, guys? This is SaberWolfHunter4, and welcome to the next Pokemon TCG overview on the Luxray line. Luxray is a fairly popular Pokemon from Gen 4, and it was proven with the recent Pokemon of the Year poll, where it placed highly in its generation. It isn't difficult to see why. It has a good cool factor going with its design, and unlike other gens, it has fairly good stats considering you can have access to Shinx pretty much in the beginning. The competitive battle in me, though, always had a small problem with this guy in the way its stats were distributed to go with its moves and typing. On the bright side, all of this goes out the window in the TCG, where any Pokemon can shine if they receive a lucky blessing from the designers, and boy did Luxray get that. As a pure mono lightning Pokemon, the Eternal line was always weak to fighting, and excluding Prince in Gen 5, they have always carried a metal resistance. The nice thing about Shinx is that numerous of its prints have had cool and special things about them. The Mysterious Treasures print had a hold item slash berry effect, a unique effect most cards never got. In this case, with its Ross berry, it will get rid of a burn. In the last true DP set, Arceus, it was honored with a shiny Pokemon secret rare, complete with a Pokebody and a payback attack that would come in handy at a desperate time. Although, to be honest, if your opponent had one prize left and you were trying to deal 40 using a 50 HP Pokemon, you had already lost. Star Barrier is a bit redundant too, but either way, this was a secret rare card with a 1 per 2 boxes ratio if I'm not mistaken. There's also the 50 HP Ultra Prism one that can evolve immediately with its ability if you go second on the first turn. Luxio didn't get the same treatment, but a few of its cards do get nice free retreat. That would be the original DP print slash pop bait print, the second Next Destinies print, and the one in Breakpoint. The Disconnect Luxio from Ultra Prism did have some slight hype and made some players curious, having an easy to use item like attack, but ultimately didn't do much given the rest of the card and the format. I guess I'm a little late to mention this, but there aren't any Japanese exclusive promos for this whole line either, only a few alternate art prints like in the Pop 8 series. Which brings us to the big feline itself. Being a DP Pokemon you can get at the start of the game, it makes sense that the original Luxray debuted in the first Diamond and Pearl set as a rare holo, a great blessing. I can't quite put my finger on it, but the rare holo cards specifically from the first DP set are exceptionally beautiful. To be quite honest with you, compared to the strongest Pokemon the first DP set brought, this Luxray wasn't very impactful. No complaints about its stats, although with this set it could have easily had 130 HP, but it only had one retreat and the metal resistance could come up. With its Gleam Eyes Pokepower, you could force your opponent to bench a basic Pokemon of your choice from their hand, assuming they had any. This kind of ability needs to be comboed with something else to be a good strategy, so it wasn't exactly the greatest thing for Luxray to get. Its only attack, Lightning Star, was also not easy to pull off, requiring a large 4 lightning energies to do 80, and always forcing you to move them on a bench Pokemon, if any. I suppose you could have tried to use this with Dragonite from Delta Species, but it wouldn't be as impressive as some other combinations using DP NEX series Pokemon. The first set of every new era is usually funky in the sense that it power creeps the previous era, but soon left in the dust with more new sets getting released. It was the case with this card too, as it would become even less impressive as following DP sets would come out. I'm gonna tell you right now though that this is the most beautiful Luxray card hands down. The next Luxray took a few sets coming in Legends Awakened, but it was much stronger, quite frankly, in every way possible. It matched the stats of the DP one, only this one had even free retreat, and it has two better attacks and a body. With Rivalry, if your opponent had any level X Pokemon in play, you were doing a whopping 50 more damage to the active Pokemon. Level X Pokemon were pretty much the face of the DP era, making this effect insanely handy with that extra damage being so generous. Plasma would do 40 for 2 while letting you attach lightning energy from the Discopod to Luxray. Very solid, helping you use Shock Bolt which did a good 100 for 3 even though you had to discard all lightning energy afterwards. The best part is that with a level X Pokemon on your opponent's field, you could get away with even just using Plasma, as doing 90 for 2 was nothing to scoff at. It wouldn't be easy to pull off, but combined with Magnezone giving you energy acceleration, or another partner, this Luxray would give your opponent nightmares if they dared to bring a level X out. Even though its pre-evolutions were alternate art cards in Pop 8, the Luxray in here is a new card. Unfortunately, it's worse than the excellent Legends Awakens print, and kind of in the same boat as the first one. It shares the same stats, getting back that one retreat, and Thunder, its only attack, can do 124-4, certainly much stronger than 80, but has the coin flip chance to damage Luxray for 40, negating any edge it would have had. It also combines pretty badly with Luxray's intimidating Fan, the only good thing about this card. If Luxray was active, you could block 10 damage from your opponent's attacks. This really is stingy damage, however, for a stage 2 body like this. Mayhaps 30 might have been too generous, but 20 would be fair enough, and that extra defense would have gone a long way. Playing card for the most part, the original Luxray at least has more potential for combos. Okay, now for the total opposite, Luxray's most famous and accomplished prince. They both appear in Ryzen Rivals and they are SP Pokemon owned by Volkner. The regular Luxray GL is the first card here, a strong basic Pokemon with good stats and strong attacks. Just by being an SP Pokemon, it gains a substantial advantage over other basic Pokemon, thanks to the SP Trainer engine working exclusively with them. So with energy gain, you have a strong 1-for-30 and a strong 2-for-70 Trash Bolt. Trash Bolt required an energy discard from the hand, but that strong and fast damage output was more than worth it. However, just left like this, while strong, it isn't groundbreaking on epic proportions. Of course, that comes with the next card, Luxray GL Level X. Not only the strongest Luxray card hands down, but one of the strongest and most dominant Pokemon of all time. It's not often that I give out the perfect card stamp, but this is a Pokemon that easily gets it. Everything from its stats, attack, and power are top tier perfect, considering the format it was printed on, of course. As an add-on to a basic Pokemon, 110 HP with Fury Retreat and a resistance that could come in handy was perfect. Flash Impact would be essentially 60-for-1, hitting one of your Pokemon for 32, but that could be mitigated with Garchomp C Level X, Luxray's greatest partner, or even Poketurns. No doubt the strongest aspect of this card, and what really made it so strong and one of a kind, was the overpowered Bright Look Pokepower. Since then, we've had a few Pokemon with that same effect, but during the 4th gen era, this power was crazy strong and something only this card could use. Gust of Wind, Pokemon Catcher, or however you want to refer to it, this effect would pull an opponent's bench Pokemon of your choice. Thanks to this power, and all the other things that made this card fast and aggressive, this Pokemon was able to prey on smaller Pokemon before they evolved or just outright kill support Pokemon without a second thought. Even crazier was the activation condition that made it work ridiculously well with Poketurn. It was the foundation of Luxchomp, one, if not the strongest, most well-rounded deck of all time, Blaziken, Luxape, and commonly used as a tech in other decks too, for being so versatile. Setting such a bar, it would be impossible for the last print in the era to surpass it, but even if it didn't, the Luxray in Arceus is still a really sweet Pokemon and possibly the second best Luxray card in the era. It matches the same good stats of the Legends Awakened print with that excellent Fury Retreat, and both of its attacks are good. Flash does a decent 1-for-30 with the chance to negate your opponent's next attack with a coin flip. Gadget Bolt is the really cool attack here. Normally, it will do 60-for-3, but if you have a Pokemon tool attached to Luxray, you can discard it and do 100 instead. This works flawlessly with Expert Belt, a tool that would boost your HP and damage, but let your opponent take 2 prizes after knocking it out. With this combo, you could do 120-for-3, with the best part being that it was compatible with DCE, and you could make this a fantastic 120-for-2. Hell, you could even put the Expert Belt on immediately and start with Flash for 50 if you know you'll survive and safely get rid of it next turn. This Pokemon could dish out amazing damage for the time, enough to one-hit KO every popular Pokemon and easily two-shot everything else. Unfortunately, this card went mostly underlooked when Luxray GL Level X was faster. It's really sad though, this card would even survive a hit against Donphan Prime if it was fresh, unlike the SP that had a x2 weakness. The story is the same with other Gen 3 and Gen 4 Pokemon. They get a few good cards in those eras and everything goes south with Gen 5. The Luxray next Destinies looks good hanging around rooftops like Spider-Man, but that's about it. It has decent 140 HP and only one retreat, and Flash Impact is an unfitting throwback that came too quick to Luxray GL Level X. It does 60-for-1 and it would only hit your Pokemon for 20, so technically it's a slight improvement, but you gotta realize this was the set when Mewtwo EX and the other EX Pokemon came out. Crunch is even worse, a straight downgrade and not even DC compatible. It couldn't even 2-hit KO EX Pokemon. Despite getting more than one print, 6th Gen was just as bad. Flashfire Luxray has, again, decent stats, but both attacks leave much to be desired. Fang Snipe is a bit unique, letting you choose to discard a trainer card in your opponent's hand, but the damage is low and it costs 2 energies. It kept it in check. Wild Charge was pitiful if you consider Black and White Zekrom was a basic Pokemon and even still around. Now that I think about it, that Zekrom puts this card to shame. Breakpoint was supposed to be Luxray's turning point, getting one of these boring level X imitations, the break cards, but it was so bad, I wager people may not even know it ever existed, let alone remember it. Technically, you could get some one-hit KOs if you got a few gets with Wild Fury, but not only were there other Pokemon that could do this gimmick faster, for the energy costs and being a break, the damage output wasn't good either. Oh, and the regular Luxray in here was also ass, so I don't even need to bother. Straight up a plain blank card. Sun and Moon did do a 180 though. We already talked about the decent pre-evolutions from Ultra Prism, and Luxray itself is no different. Bearing solid stats for the era with 150 HP and Free Retreat, this card is still legal in Standard right now, but difficult to use. The most appealing thing about it, it's certainly Voltbolt, a 150 damage snipe for 3, and you have to discard all lightning energies. By no means is this the greatest trade-off for energies and damage output, but because it was a snipe, it still made it appealing. The real curse that held back this card was being a stage 2. Pokemon like Magnezone and Electric could have been viable partners if that wasn't the case. I myself wanted to find a good way to use this card, but it didn't work out, and now Cramorant V ensures its attack is obsolete. The other nice thing about it was Intimidating Fang, blocking 30 damage from attacks if this guy was active. Pop Luxray throwback this time. Overall, this card is good on paper, but sadly had to miss the mark. Before I finish, I want to quickly look at the Rebellious Clash line while I'm at it. The line loses the metal resistance again, like the one in Gen 5, and both pre-evolutions have a decent trick on their sleeve. Shinx can do 60 for 1 if your opponent has taken 3 or more prize cards, and Luxio can instantly be placed on the bench if you draw it at the beginning of the turn. This latest Luxray probably won't do much to lift its downhill legacy. It has some okay stats, but not really, considering the times we're in, and with Raid, you can do 160 for 1 if you evolve from Luxio this turn. Perhaps the set will enable players to regain this effect easily, as there are other Pokemon here sharing Luxio's ability, but I'm not that optimistic. Then again, I could be missing something. This concludes our lengthy, but hopefully enjoyable TCG overview on the Luxray line. Luxray's legacy and successful cards are entirely in its debutant era, with every other era afterwards letting it down somehow. Ultra Prism was the closest set to let the line make a comeback, but ultimately didn't work out, and Luxray Break, the only other special card it got besides the SP Duo, was a useless waste of time. TCG-wise, it is one of the most unique Pokemon out there. It has many bad cards under its name. But that same Pokemon also has one half of Luxchomp, the most dominant deck of the DP era. Since then, it never regained that status, and there's a good chance it never will. But OGs of the Pokemon TCG will never forget that legacy, and ultimately, it's a legendary achievement nearly any other Pokemon would love to have. Thanks for watching, and hopefully enjoying. If there's a line you'd like to see next, comment down below and I might do it. Like and share this video with your fellow TCG players, I'm sure they'll find some value from it, and subscribe for more videos like this eventually, and just everything Pokemon TCG. Sabro Final 4, wazzup!